Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Starfleet Academy with me, your instructor, Get Daved. Oh, we forgot to rest at the end of our sophomore year. All right, class is now being taught by a marketing executive slash business douche. I only have one textbook, Sun Tzu's Art of War. I haven't read it. It's on my shelf, though. Two copies. Accidentally bought a second one. Never noticed. All right, welcome to a real ship. This is my favorite ship in all of Star Trek. Not that I'm an expert, but I really liked it. Oh goodness, the Phoenix. All right. It's awful. We know very little. Not to our knowledge. How do you know it exists if we've never seen it and no one we know has ever seen it? All right, well, let's go check out our outposts. So, fun fact, Nintendo Power, Sensor One Destroyed, which was an old magazine. Can't talk to the escape pods. Plasma torpedoes. All right, that's the Phoenix. Nintendo Power had this contest, and they would do things like post your high scores, take a picture, and include your Nintendo so we know you weren't cheating. It was a simpler time. Outpost 2 is destroyed. Anyway, they did a contest to this just to see who could have the highest GPA at the end of Star Trek, Starfleet Academy, Starship Bridge Simulator. Romulan crews are on intercept course. They have plasma torpedoes, but let's chat. Surrender or we will attack you. No, I want answers. Okay. Some renegades. Yeah, thanks for coming to help. We came to spy on you. Might have been them. We could try destroying them. We only have one colony on the map, so let's go for it. Anyway, one person wrote in. Only one person responded to the contest. Sensor sweep? There's a Phoenix somewhere. We asked for the Federation's help against Romulan oppression. Oh. Okay. Well, we rumble. The important thing is to survive that opening volley, because I think it can lob two plasma torpedoes. I don't really remember. It's just really hard, and we have a limited amount of time. It's dangerous, and I don't want to die. Anyway, the one person who responded to the contest said in the Power magazine that this was the most arduous mission. And they like had it in quotes because they were like, can you believe this guy used the word arduous? And that was the first time I learned that or heard that word with Purd. Ah, oh, it's got a nasty hitbox too. All right, we're gonna loop around. Oh, we actually could have crashed and lost everything right there. So time is not our friend here. We have a limited amount of time, and then it just retreats. Okay. What you really want to do is get the cloak. Oh. We're having a pretty non-eventful battle, which will work for a little bit. This is indeed the hardest one per game in the game. Oh, we hit something. Gonna throttle back the speed a bit. You can see the constitution can go almost to 3/4. That's our speed on the right, by the way. Comes to my attention, I've never really explained any of the UI but the sensor. Come on. On the left is our shields. Yeah. I mean, I partly just led the target wrong. They zigged less than I thought they would. On the left is our phaser indicator. You usually get pairs of shots. On the right is our torpedoes. It's green if you have any ready to go. Come on, we really need to get a nice destructive volley in. Doesn't help. Okay. Come on. Yeah, you guys could... I wish there were, I don't know, more of a drawback. Cloaking devices are super overpowered in this game. There we go. They rocked us with a plasma torpedo, but we got their cloak. Now we can lay into them. I'm gonna need speed though. I gotta stay on them. I actually might have hit them where it hurts. You can see how fast it is though. Come on. Yeah, I think their weapons have been damaged. We gotta get them again before. Yeah, like taking a plasma torpedo is not good, for example. Come on. Oh, die, die, die. We have one brief moment. It is possible to get it. All right, run away, you coward. Run away to go spend a Crate and Barrel gift card. All right. Phoenix has retreated. Mission accomplished. Stand down, red alert. All right. I'd say we were successful. Man, I'm really glad we hit them. I mean, with the Phoenix, its shields are pretty strong. You basically, and it cloaks so much and it's so fast, you basically just have to hit it when it's cloaked and knock its cloak offline. That's your only real chance. And we got a pretty good licking in there and it really opened up everything else. Let us go head to head and get plasma torpedoed right from the front. Not every day you can do that. Mission accomplished. Whew. All right, that's the hardest mission in the game, everybody. There's still another really hard one following it, because I remember you get a 1-2 punch that's pretty nasty. This Muscan Seed Punch. Hey, good drinks, everyone. You know what, Everett? Sometimes talking about problems doesn't help. I was raised on the school of thought that it's like, you gotta talk it out, but you know what? Sometimes letting it not dictate your attention is a good thing. Oh, I see, I assumed it was Venturi Renegades. But I'll leave the rest to you. What a pretentious jerk. I'm awful. Mike Everett is terrible. As well as can be expected. Oh, you can guess. A little bit worse after talking to you. Oh, there's a scimitar, which is... Man, that is silly. Yeah, that was pretty neat. This is actually very good. Jones has done it again. Alright. Hope you all enjoyed that. Now, can be dealt with by a skilled diplomat. See, I thought this was the Fight the Excelsior mission. There we go. Go. Galway, Manitoba, Hansu, and Kumasi. Hansu is a great Overwatch character. Yep. You got it. Yes, it has double the firepower, full speed, way better acceleration, stronger shields, and more hull. Alright, let's do it. But it can't hide on you. Alright, Kumasi, what you got? Alright, let's pump it up to red alert here. Yeah, in the simulator, you can input a code and play as the Excelsior, and it's got some gumption. You could probably take two Phoenixes pretty easily. Alright. It's out. We're not gonna catch it in time. Alright, we battle in the Manitoba sector. There it is. Big ol' bulky Excelsior. We gotta get up to speed right away. Cause we don't wanna go head to head with this thing. For different reasons than the Phoenix. I already screwed up. Like all ships, it has a nasty hitbox. Yeah, you can see the one that actually was a little bit low is the one that hit. But I mean, I make fun of this game a lot, but you can see what they're... Oh, it was nearly game over. You can see what they're trying to do. You know, establishing characters. I'm teasing them a lot in the interactions, but... Come on. All astern! Also, everybody... Oh, boy. We have a bit of a dogfighting problem, and we have limited time. Yeah, one shot. Good for you. Good for you. You can see we've wailed on it and haven't dropped its shields down. You can actually sometimes watch them regenerate as they go back to green. Didn't quite tear at the new one I hoped to. Hope you're setting up the atmosphere really nice. You know, dim the lights, unless you want some nice, optimistic, next-generation lighting. Okay, come on. Didn't hit us very hard. I think it torpedoed us. It has four torpedoes, just like a Constitution, but it can fire them a lot faster. And see, it's not doing a ton of damage to our shields, though. That's what you need your phasers for, buddy. Come on. Look at that thing, just take a beating. Boom. Like nothing. But seriously, when you fly that thing, it's a killing machine. Destroy it before it can reach all four checkpoints. Marginal success, everybody. Also, remember, Starfleet is about diplomacy and exploration, despite the fact that they're just training me to kill. Kill this guy, kill that guy. Alright. Let's zip out of here. The trailer for Star Trek Discovery came out today. Like, I don't know, a new one. It looked like a bad trailer. We'll see about the show. Well done, cadets. That's right, well done. I've kind of wondered if there's a glitch that makes an Excelsior's torpedoes not work very well, but we still have slaughtered that thing. Let's graduate first. Nice. Yeah, I think there's something to be said for that. That's fair. Which is actually ties into... It always drives me crazy when, like, people are super into futurology, like, talk about how, like, some technological innovation will change the world, and it's like... You can, in my opinion, pretty much look at all of human history, and every level of technological achievement has just led us to do the same sorts of things, just on different scales and different ways. I mean, it doesn't change people. Ooh. You know him? He needs money. I'm sure that was an episode. It's impressive. Ah, the engineer who loves it. Nice. Preaching Sturrock's philosophy. Yeah, I mean, that's for next year. I think we had a little continuity error there. Alright, let's cram in one more. Science and diplomacy. Consider myself to have a pretty good transcript, that's what. Go directly to the Demeter protostar and monitor unusual space-time rifts. Don't get too close. How close is too close? Also, yeah, space-time rifts. I probably should have keyed in on that. All right. I'm gonna go on to the other side. That's probably an automatic fail. Also, it looked like there was one interesting sector on the map. Oh, you know something bad's gonna happen here. Well, it's just my imagination. Sensor sweep? Yeah, what about the protostar, buddy? Readings are off the scale. Whoa! A Tholian and a Gorn cruiser. We are the Zai. We have brought you here to examine which of your species is the strongest. All right. Let the battle begin. We are not a warship. Okay, I should probably raise the shield. Oh, or hail someone. A lot of muscle memory playing in there. Okay. This cannot be resolved. I could kill everyone. Honestly, once the Phoenix is taken care of. We know how to beat the Zai. Alright, let's do this. I wish I knew. Looks like the Tholians and the Gorn are going at it back there. You're kinda in my... Was it all a dream? I don't know what happened. Well, I guess we had to leave green space? Well, 100%. I'm tired. Yeah, they're wearing out the people programming them too, apparently. What do I get? Hey! Everett's is a bit of a dick. Alright. Although he's been very diplomatic there. Man. That said, I've met a few people like Ken Elliott. I wonder what he compared it to. It's another year. Regard the universe as a classroom. Yeah, no one else has that philosophy. You guys thought of that. Hey, zing! Ah. Oh, alright, I like that. That's a solid burn. Shots fired. Let's sneak in one more here. We'll mow through that last one pretty quickly. Yeah, I'm showing off my transcript. I have a 4.0. Any opponents, you should keep moving. See, you can usually get away with it. I'm a big believer in the best defense is a good offense, though. Prevent goals by having puck possession. And cycling to the correct option. Alright, controller's being a little fishy again. It's trying to tell me something. The next series of six simulators, What If War? Okay. Now to the first mission. Yeah, I'm sure we didn't do anything. When you found it, return to Starbase. I don't know who the Organians are, but I believe Princess Leia is one of them. Alright, so don't bite off more than you can chew. Okay, we're gonna zip here. So, pro tip. You can put up the old shields. If you go to red alert, basically, and then warp in, the torpedo rack will be fully loaded. So it's a little better than reacting later. Oh boy. I guess I could leave right away? I think we're at a bit of a disadvantage here. Alright, a battle cruiser. Got ourselves a real opponent. Come on. Oh, I think we're a little too tight now. Nearly a collision disaster, but that's okay. Alright, you've stuck around this long. It's time for me to reveal the deep, dark secret about this series. It was almost like the second Let's Play I ever did. Maybe a bit later than that. And like years ago, near the beginning, in like one Get Daved era, oh boy, that was bad of me. I recorded this entire Let's Play. And it was 12 episodes long, because back then you had a 10-minute cap for video length on YouTube. Come on. There we go. Let's see how we're doing. Okay. Again, torpedoes usually don't do too much damage through the shields. Next. And I don't think I was doing as well as I am now, but I recorded Is this a bird of prey? Yeah, I'm not sticking around. Yeah, look, it's already trashed me. We have found the supply depot. Look at this thing. Knocked my photons offline. I mean, I found the supply depot, but let's just complete our scanning. Two cruisers? No, thank you. We'll drop down to yellow alert and then leave. Hey, eat me! Anyway, I recorded it in 12 episodes, had it all just sitting there, and then thought, nah, and deleted the entire thing. I was like, this game's not very good. But it piques your curiosity. You found the depot. All right, we got to Home Depot, everybody. Let's brood with our colleagues and then call it an episode. They always get tougher. No, they really peaked with the Phoenix. I hope we do well on the upcoming scenarios. That's a real divisive thing to say. I can't help but think this is a pickup line. Go get some sleep. Aw, thanks, Jones. You're a sympathetic bartender. Alright, next time, maybe we make it to senior year. I'll see you there.